Having your degree online is closer than you think.
Hold on, guys. These damn ads.
Behold the king. He deserves the king of kings.
This man deserves my respect. Welcome to In Between the Ropes. This will be going on both channels. Welcome. Welcome to In Between the Ropes. Welcome to In Between the Ropes, everyone. Welcome to your episode. Welcome once again to another episode of In Between the Ropes. Welcome to your Monday Night Raw review. Sorry I didn't do it last night, but here you go. Sorry I didn't get back to you last night. I just think this is over. Sorry I didn't get back to you guys last night. It was, you know, I wasn't feeling well. Stomach ache and everything, but sorry I didn't do Monday Night Raw. I'm here tonight to do. I'm here this morning to do it for you. So I'm back for another video. Was Monday Night Raw good? It was good. I'm not saying it was bad. It was a very, very good show. I'm not saying all of it was good. The show was kind of, it still needs a little work. Triple H needs to work on the show better. Monday Night Raw is still a fucking, excuse my language, I gotta stop swearing. Still a friggin' circus. It still needs a lot of work. Triple H has to work on Monday Night Raw. He has to work on it. The superstars need a lot of work. And they need that insurance, you know, of, you know, what's going on and what's happening to them. You know, Monday Night Raw is becoming a circus again. I mean, really. 4 hours of boredom. But the best thing of Monday Night Raw, the best thing of it was the bloodline. The bloodline makes that show better. And even Judgment Day. Anything else on that show sucks. Let's put it that way. It sucks. You want to watch 4 hours of Monday Night Raw. You got to bring Monday Night Raw to back to the olden days when it was Austin, The Rock, back to the Attitude Era. You need to look back on the olden days of Monday Night Raw. Back to when wrestling used to be good. You got all these superstars now that are brand spanking new. You want to change the landscape. You got to make it better. I don't know if Vince McMahon is backstage writing the show still, but they got to get better at it. Monday Night Raw needs a change. If Cody comes back, that's the change in the right direction for Monday Night Raw. Cody needs to come back. They need some superstars on Raw. This show is sinking. It's tanking. SmackDown is better. Right now, SmackDown's the number one show. They got Ray Wyatt. They got the Bloodline. They got John Cena. They got everything. Why would you want to change? You need to change. You need to make Monday Night Raw used to be the flagship of WWE programming. And now what is it? It's a joke. It's a joke. I like Triple H. I do. I think he's doing a great job in talent relations. But this has got to change, Triple H. It's got to change. You need to bet. This show's got to be written better. It just got to. What he's doing with the Bloodline is perfect. But these hijinks that Vince McMahon put into the show, they got to go. They have to go. It isn't working. It didn't work then, and it's not going to work now. It never did. It never fit into the WWE programming. It never fit in to anything. What is it that WWE wants? What do the fans want? The fans want new crap. I'm 38, okay? I watched WWE since I was a little kid, okay? I want adult television. I watch AEW. That's adult television, not PG crap. It's gotta go. It's gotta go. Nobody wants to see unicorns anymore. Nobody wants to see pancakes anymore. Get real. Nobody wants to see that crap anymore. I like New Day. Get rid of them. Get rid of the unicorns. Get rid of the pancakes. It's got to go. The adults want adult TV. They want WWE to be Raw. Where's the Raw? And Monday Night Raw. You got it in that Music Street Steve fight. Great, between Solo Sikoa and Elias. Great match. That's Raw. But that's the only match you got on the card that was good. You got an idiot going, shush! What's that? What's entertaining about the Afro Academy? They don't entertain me, they bore me. Shush! What is that? Is that a teacher going shh in a library? It's stupid. It sucks. It's a dumb gimmick. It stinks. It doesn't fit in the show. That Dustin Lumis match sucked. He rolls them up in a pack as the match is over. Who finds that entertaining? I'm going to get into the big part in a minute. Who finds that entertaining? Not me. I found it boring. Shush! That's entertaining? Give me a break. Shush! Shush! Get the hell out of here with that crap. Boring as hell. It's like watching Zing. He should go join Nikki Cross and they should dress up and they should go Zing. Shush! Zing! Shush! Zing! Stupid. Stupid. Boring. Put me to sleep. And then you got the other idiots running around. It looks like a freaking circus. Barnum Bailey's. Get some tickets. You want to go see Monday Night Raw? The circus is in town. Now we get to the big part. Alexa Bliss. And Bianca Belair. Now this match was so stupid. You could even see the signs for poor Ray Wyatt. Bianca is a good champion. But they made it look like a joke. Alexa didn't do anything good in that match. Her moves were terrible. They are going in the wrong direction with Ray Wyatt. They're starting to give Alexa Bliss some character traits of Ray Wyatt again. This is what killed Ray Wyatt in the first place. This is what got Ray Wyatt fired. This is what got Ray Wyatt done with WWE in the first freaking place. Alexa Bliss. She has nothing to do with the Ray Wyatt character. She has nothing to do with it. What in the hell is she doing with Ray Wyatt's character? She has nothing to do with Uncle Howdy. She has nothing to do with Ray Wyatt or any of it. She's involved now. Now, granted, she was a great Harley Quinn character when she was with The Fiend. But then they killed off Ray Wyatt. They killed him. And she's coming out with a Lily doll. I I don't know if they're reacting to Conjuring or what. But now they're bringing back Alexa Bliss. They want to make her part of the Wyatt sex. This is stupid. They're going to kill Ray Wyatt before he gets started. I mean, this is a terrible thing that could happen to Ray right now in his career. Bringing her back into his character. They're going to kill Ray before he gets started. Right now, Ray Wyatt, the way he's going right now is great. Ray Wyatt, the real Ray Wyatt, the real character. The real guy you see. That's the Ray Wyatt I like too, like JD says. I like it too. But you bring her back into the fold, you're going to kill the man's character. It won't mean nothing. I mean, it won't mean crap. What does she have to do with it? She has nothing to do with Ray Wyatt. She shouldn't even be involved. You know why she wants to get involved? Money. Because she can't wrestle. Like JD said. She can wrestle. She's a great wrestler. What happened to the Bliss that we used to know? I like that Alexa Bliss. The Bliss that used to nail people and call herself the Queen Bliss. Now I like that one. The real conniving Alexa Bliss. Now that's Alexa Bliss I like. When she used to put the title on her neck. That's the Alexa Bliss I like. But what we're getting now is a joke. She's going to kill Ray Wyatt. She's going to kill Ray Wyatt. Just like she killed The Fiend. And then we're getting at the Royal Rumble, LA Knight versus Ray Wyatt in a pitch dark black match. What's that? What are we going to watch at the Rumble? And I'm watching on Saturday because I want to see those AFC games, Jason. What's that? Pitch dark black match. Jason wants to see Rumble. He's going to have to come on Saturday. Pitch dark black match. What is that? What is that? What are we going to see? Two wrestlers rustling around in the dark and they can't see each other? It's like watching when the lights went out during the show in 1996, Beware of Dogs. Nobody wants to see that. And then Ray Wyatt is dying. Why don't they just kill the character? He should go to AEW. I said it. Come back W was a mistake, Ray. Should have went to AEW, Ray. Big mistake, Ray. I'm pissed because of it. Because they're going to kill you, Ray. You know, I thought this was a good thing for you, Ray. I thought these Hollywood writers would be good for Ray Wyatt. I thought this was going to be a great thing for Ray, and you're bringing Alexa Bliss back into the fold. You're doing the same thing you did to him when Vince was in charge. And it's wrong. This man deserves a lot more respect than what he's getting. He lost his best friend. And now you're doing this to him again. You're doing the same crap you did to him back in 2021. Doesn't deserve it. He doesn't. He's got to stop with all this demonic crap. It's not helping his career at all. He should just be Ray Wyatt. Just be a regular wrestler. Because all this horror crap is not helping his career. All these venue ads and all these I'm here, the lantern. It's nice. It's awesome. I think it's cool that he comes out and be himself. That was the best thing. That was the real him. When he talked about Brody Lee and everything, what he went through. But what they're doing to him now, they're killing his wrestling career. They're just killing the man, the wrestler, the character of this man. This man wants a legacy to leave behind, and he's got to leave all this crap behind. I think drop the horror stuff. It's not working. It's not. I know a lot of people are going to say, well, it does work for him. It doesn't. I think Uncle Howdy's a good thing. You should start a rivalry with him and just be Ray Wyatt. A good guy now. A baby face. Just be regular Ray Wyatt with that new song he has and Uncle Howdy. But leave her the hell out of it. Because she is going to wreck the friggin' storyline. You put her in it, it just doesn't make any sense. Watch Raw if you don't believe me. She was going nuts in the ring. She started being the old Alexa Bliss. Do I like the Harley Quinn one? No. Because it killed Ray Wyatt. At first I did. I thought it was good for the Fiend to have her around. But then she started acting stupid. She killed the Fiend. Randy Orton beats him at WrestleMania in a what? A 3-second match? That's all we freaking got. Stupid. You got her coming out of a stupid box of blood coming out of her mouth, and the Fiend's looking at her like. And Randy Orton RKOs him, and he goes in the box and he disappears. That's Vince. Nothing changes. Monday Night Raw's gotta change, and they gotta keep Ray Wyatt and leave her the hell out of the freaking character. Leave her the frig out. She has nothing to do with it. She should just be regular Alexa Bliss, the bad girl she's always been. The old Alexa Bliss. They're gonna kill Ray Wyatt before he gets started. Leave her the frig out of it. She has nothing to do with Ray Wyatt's career. Leave her the frig out of it, Triple H. She has nothing to friggin' do with it. She sucks for his career. Stupid. She can't even wrestle anyways. She doesn't excite me anyways. But back to Raw. Raw was good. It needs a little work, like I said. If they bring back Cody, it's going to be the step in the right direction. They got to bring back Cody. Do I like that Paul, that Triple H is running things? Yes, I do. I know the Royal Rumble is going to be good. And I want to apologize to Russell Talk. Russell Talk, I mentioned a lot of podcasters in my last one that I did here. By the way, I'm uploading this to both channels. Russell Talk, I'm sorry. I mentioned I don't like Joe Cronin and I don't like Russell Talk, but I do like Russell Talk and JD. They are my two favorites. Russell Talk, I do like you. I do like JD from New York and Russell Talk. I like the both of them. They're very, very good. And Russell Observer and Dave Meltzer, who gives the news. Other than that, I do not like Joe Cronin. Can't stand him. But I do like Russell Talk and JD from New York and Russell Observer. That's it. Those are the only three podcasts I like on here. Other than that, I do not like Joe Cronin. Can't stand him. Sounds like Gordon Drano. Can't stand him, guys. Sorry. But I do like Russell Talk. Sorry, Russell Talk. I got a little mad at the end of that video. I should have mentioned I didn't like you, but I do like you. I'm one of your fans. And I do like JD. He is my favorite. JD is my number one, though. JD and Russell Talk are my favorites, and Russell's over. That's it. It's the only podcasters I watch on here. And Zerger, I still like you too, buddy. You're still my favorite. Please subscribe to Zerger. You need 300 now. We have 90 people, which is great. I wish you can keep subscribing. Our goal now is to reach 100. I hope we can reach 100. Thank you for subscribing. I like to welcome the 90 fans, and we have 19 on the other channel. I do have another channel. In between the ropes are my podcast that I do on the David and Jason show, and I also am going to do on my other channel, my music channel I used to have. And I will be uploading this on both channels and other videos I do on the David and Jason show with Jason and Ashley and me. But I do want to say welcome to the 90 fans. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for joining the channel and the podcast. I hope you enjoy the podcast. I do the best I can. But like I said, Monday Night Raw has got to change. Triple H is doing a great job, but he's got to change Raw. It's got to be a... I hope they go to a rated R era, because this has got to change. They got to go to Netflix, because commercials are driving me nuts. I can't stand USA and Fox anymore. They got to move. They got to stream on Netflix. No commercials would be the best thing. I'm getting sick of commercials. It's driving me nuts. Because we missed half of the damn match. You go live, you don't miss anything. I know commercials pay for networks, but damn. When you watch a basketball game, at least you get a break. You can see the whole game. But this, you don't get crap. Oh, I'm going to be doing basketball as well on this channel. But... probably call that NBA talk. Maybe I should call that something else, but I don't know. But Raw's got to change. It's got to change. SmackDown is number one. I got nothing bad to say about SmackDown. The Bloodline. What do I think about that going in the right direction? Well, it is going in the right direction right now. I know sooner or later Roman's going to turn on Sammy. It's going to happen. It's bound to happen. Not yet, but it's going to happen before the Rumble, before WrestleMania. I think Cody's going to be the number one contender for Roman's belt. I think that's what's going to happen. I think what's going to happen is Sammy is going to enter the Rumble and not win it. But what I think is going to happen is Sammy is going to enter the Elimination Chamber with KO. And they're going to decide to double team Roman. And that's when Roman is going to turn on Sammy. I think one night he's going to try to, you know, probably play Sammy with an honorary, the one shirt. You're the one. And have Soto hold him up on his shoulders, you know, like Evolution did to Eugene. And dump him and beat the crap out of him. That's what I think's going to happen. And KO's going to come out and try to help him. And that's going to lead to a match between KO and the Usos for the belts. That's what I think is going to happen. I don't think Sammy's going to stay in the Bloodline much longer. I don't know if they're going that route yet, but I really think it's all going to culminate at Elimination Chamber. I don't think the Rumble's going to end it yet, but I think it's all going to culminate at the Elimination Chamber. I think Sami Zayn is going to be turned on after the Elimination Chamber. After the Elimination Chamber, that's when WrestleMania weekend starts. And probably in March, that's when Sammy will be kicked out of the Bloodline. And then when WrestleMania comes around, Sammy and KO will be together again. That's what I think is really going to happen. That's the route they're going for. The Usos and Sami Zayn. And Roman will definitely fight Cody. And Cody's going to definitely get the belts. I think... The American Nightmare is going to win the Rumble. and get the titles. I don't think Ray Wyatt's going to get it yet. I don't think they're ready to give it to Ray. I think Ray's going to start a fight with Uncle Howdy. And that's going to culminate at WrestleMania. Probably with the idiot Alexa Bliss. She'll probably interfere and screw it up. But I really think that everything's going to culminate after the Elimination Chamber. I really think that Uncle Howdy will fight Ray at WrestleMania. That's what I think is going to happen. And then we might get the reveal of the Wyatt sex. And if she's a part of it, if she doesn't frig it up, hopefully it'll be a good year for Ray. If she doesn't screw it up, if they leave her the hell out of it, what they should do, she can't wrestle for crap. But Ray should be in the center of it all. You know what I mean? Because Alexa's got no talent at all with this crap. She just should be the old Alexa Bliss. She can wrestle. Sorry, I shouldn't have said that. But Ray should be in the center of it. You know? This is Ray's year to come back and be Ray Wyatt. Cody's going to have both belts. He's probably going to defend it. And I think he's going to start a rivalry with Seth. Again. What I really think, everything's going to culminate at the Rumble. That's when everything's going to start. The road to WrestleMania. We're going to get a Paul Levesque Royal Rumble. The woman, I don't know what he's doing with the women's belts yet. I have really no idea what he's doing with the women's division. They gotta spice that up a little bit. Ronda Rousey is driving me crazy. Charlotte Flair is the women's champion. My name is Charlotte Flair. The android. Fake tits and all. But she's back. Charlotte's back with her fake boobs and everything. My name is Charlotte Flair. She needs a flotation of life for her tits. But she is back. The android has returned. So she is the woman's champion again. And I don't know the route they're going with the SmackDown women's title. I don't know what they're doing with the women's division. So I don't know what the women's rumble is going to be about. I have no clue who's going to fight Ronda, who's going to fight Flair, or who's going to fight Ivanka. It doesn't really seem like the women's division is going anywhere. The women's tag belts, I don't know where that's going. So, you know, Paul Levesque's got to spice this up. You know, he's got to make it a good rumble to compete with ADW, which I don't know if he can. But he has teamed up with AAA in New Japan Wrestling, so it's interesting to see what he's going to do with that, because I read that on the news. That's going to be good. He has teamed up with AAA, Jason. He got the Red Dragon from ADW, I forget his name. I'm learning, guys, I'm learning. But he did team up with AAA in New Japan. So, man, if he gets some of those guys from New Japan Wrestling, he'll be golden. He's partnered up with AAA. So he's doing real good. If he gets some of the New Japan guys, he's going to be good. For NXT and coming into WWE. So Cody is returning. We got a glimpse of him on Monday Night Raw. Cody's coming back. So he will be back at the Rumble. That's going to be... Jason will be happy to hear that news. Because I know Jason likes the American Nightmare and I do too. Cody is coming back, bud. And also... we'll see how the Royal Rumble goes with Paul Levesque. So let's hope Monday Night Raw changes. So I hope you like this review. Like, subscribe, favorite. So hit that notification bell. Hit that subscribe button and like and favorite. And don't forget, put Jesus first. Bye for now, guys. Hope you enjoyed this review. Don't forget, I'm uploading this both channels. Bye for now.